Hello there, everybody. My name is Stan Werben. I'm at Elderly Instruments in Lansing, Michigan. We have here a very special S.S. Stewart banjo from around 1890, which was the very early days of when S.S. Stewart started making banjos like this one. This is a presentation champion model, but the important part is that it's a presentation model, which means that it's got all kinds of frou-frou on it. I don't know if they had that word in the 1890s, but it's got just a lot of stuff that makes you go, ooh, look at that. And all of these presentation model banjos were custom made for individuals from music stores through the S.S. Stewart Company. So every one of them is a little different. And in fact, they're often a lot different. And this one's pretty different. First of all, it's a really nice banjo as an instrument. The S.S. Stewart banjos are considered one of the better and definitely the largest manufacturer of quality banjos. They were made in Philadelphia started making banjos in the early 1880s, I think, and made them until S.S. Stewart's death in 1898. After that, the S.S. Stewart name continued, but under different management and somewhat different instruments. Not to say that the later ones are bad, but the best ones are from this time period. This particular instrument, as a presentation model, as I say, has a lot of fancy stuff on it. The headstock inlays are very elaborate, leaves and butterflies and flower pots, nicely engraved. And then there's a kind of a mixture of fancy inlays on the fingerboard. Also, you take a look at the back, and if you just start at the top again, you see, okay, look at that kind of fancy carving on the back of the headstock. Not something you see very often on any banjos, even in the old days. This again is a carving of a flower pot with flowers. The heel carving is really pretty astonishing. It's a lion's head, probably 7 or 8, 9 inches worth of carving from the rim up to where my thumb is right here. And again, a lot of fancy flowers and pretty heavily engraved. The dowel stick itself is carved in a manner that mostly S.S. Stewart did, but a few other people did things like this too. But it's just a very attractively carved dowel stick instead of the usual kind of plain dowel stick you see on most banjos. The inside of the rim is wood, and as are most S.S. Stewart banjos, they're usually what's called a spun-over rim with metal on the outside and wood on the inside. And if you look at the inside, you see, on this particular one, you see all kinds of marquetry. There's flowers and, I don't know, pinwheels? What do they got there? It's hard to tell what some of this is, but it's just very fancy and very attractive looking. The outside of the rim has very nicely engraved flowers all the way around. Is it a Joseph Rogers? It has a Joseph Rogers head on it, which says to me this could be original. Hard to say for sure, but it's definitely an old skin head, probably at least from the 1930s, but it could go back farther as well. So again, this is because of all this stuff. It's a very very attractive collector's item kind of banjo. Right now, it doesn't play quite as well as I would like it to, and that is fairly easily remedied. And the part of the reason we're selling it as it is, which is to say, without it playing quite as well as we would have most of our instruments playing, is because there are a lot of people who might want to set this up different ways, and how you would do that might depend on you. And so, but if you want us to do it, you should talk to us, and we can get that accomplished as well. In terms of originality, it's almost all the important stuff's original. There are 5 hooks and nuts that are not original, I believe. No, maybe 4 or 5 hooks and nuts that are not original. There are modern gear tuners on it, which are not original, and as well as a geared fifth peg, and also a newer tailpiece. I think everything else is pretty straight, which means this is eminently restorable to original if that's what you want. If you want a more modern playing banjo, however, all the stuff is on it already. It's got the right tailpiece, it's got the right tuners, and so whether you want to play in classic style, or if you want to play in clawhammer style, or any other style you choose on the banjo, this banjo can be set up to play just right for any of those styles, and it's not too bad the way it is, I should say. It's not just not quite as tweaked the way we would want it to be. And so that being said, take a look at it on our website, and if you have any questions, give us a holler. Thanks very much for watching.